There are many things great about public transit in Singapore, from high frequencies to a fully wheelchair accessible system. In this video, I'll be sharing various transit priority schemes used in Singapore. Here's why transit priority is needed. A single deck bus could carry around 80 passengers each, and that for a double deck or an articulated bus would be over 130. Whereas for cars, they can carry approximately 5 people each, with an average occupancy of 1.4, this makes cars way more space inefficient than buses. As of 2018, there are 4 million bus trips made every day, and by prioritizing buses to allow more efficient operations, it can draw people who are still relying on private vehicles to make the switch. This creates a cycle of reducing car dependence and increasing transit efficiency. Here are some examples of transit priority in Singapore. Let's start off with bus stops. Certain bus stops have mandatory giveaway schemes. In such places, a yellow box is painted on the lane next to the bus stop. Ample warning is given by mandatory giveaway signs on the left, as well as road markings with the sharp end of the triangle pointing towards 1 when driving along. People driving must give way to buses exiting the bus stop, and when needed, stop behind the yellow box. Their journey can be continued after buses have completed merging out from the bus bay. This makes buses faster, as bus captains do not need to wait for gaps in the traffic before continuing on their route. If there is a need for a bus to filter across multiple lanes of heavy traffic, signals can prioritize bus movement. There are two variants used here, one being the B signal, and the other being a separate signal. In the first variant, the traffic light is placed after the bus stop. Such signals with bus priority have an extra lamp on the left side which illuminates a B sign in green to allow buses to proceed through the crossing. This is done so before the red signal turns green for other drivers. Here's an example along Tampines Avenue 7. Where the B signal allows a bus captain to filter to the right turning lane easily. In the second variant, the traffic light is positioned in the middle of the bus stop. These signals typically remain green for traffic on the road, except when needed by buses to merge out. In such places, induction loops are placed at the bus stop and are triggered when a bus occupies the space above. These signals are fitted with a delay, which turns the signal red for traffic on the road if the bus is unable to exit from the bus bay after a set duration. Bus priority on lanes under rarity in Singapore, with many bus lanes installed here. Bus lanes can be used by buses and bicycles riding in single file. There are three types of bus lanes here: normal, full day, and bus-only lanes. Normal lanes are demarcated by a thick yellow line on the right side of the bus lane and are operational during peak hours. Full-day bus lanes have a red and yellow line and are operational from early morning till late night. Bus-only lanes are demarcated by a red line and are strictly reserved for buses throughout the day. When the lane markings become dashed, they become shared spaces which can be used by other drivers to turn into side streets along the main road. This, however, slows buses down in the lane, as shown in my video about strokes. The operational hours of bus lanes may vary based on the day of the week, but fret not if you have a tiny brain like me, as this information can be found on signs located at the start of bus lanes. To enter specific compounds in certain areas, bus turning lanes are provided to aid the movement of buses. The most common location where these are found are near interchanges for buses to make a right turn in. In other places, bus turning lanes are provided to create faster connections by buses. For example, near Scape at Somerset Road, buses can make a left turn after yielding to people walking at a zebra crossing, while everyone else has to wait for the traffic signal in addition to yielding to people walking. At Braddell Flyover, a bus lane is made to allow buses heading to Lorong Chuan to bypass multiple signals under the flyover. Although most lanes are operational at all times, some can be used by all vehicles outside of their operational hours. In addition to bus turning lanes, there are also bus-only roads. These are created to ease bus access to stops along the way, and at times, provide access to places out of bounds to other vehicles. Such lanes are operational at all times. Many of these can be found along the AYE, providing commuters opportunities to transfer to other bus services. Outside Tampines Interchange, a bus-only lane is made to a bus stop for buses heading towards Tampines Concourse. Connaught Drive, which provides direct access to the Esplanade Park and the Padang, is also limited to bus access. Although such schemes are typically implemented along arterial roads, a neighbourhood road in Woodlands was converted to a bus-only road as part of a trial. I've made a video about it, and the link to it is in the description box below. One transit priority scheme which sadly has not been rolled out across Singapore is priority at regular traffic lights. However, trials for such technologies have been done in the past, such as the use of transponders on Bus 700 in 1998, giving rise to its name, Rapid Bus. In 2018, buses 98 and 99 were equipped with trackers to allow priority at traffic intersections. This results in bus commuters spending 10% less time waiting at traffic signals, and headway regulation was improved by 16%. This trial, however, concluded in 2019 with no news of widespread implementation. A scheme which will be made more common in the future though is transit priority corridors. Currently, one road having such a scheme is the south half of Bencoolen Street. This scheme will be implemented in the upcoming North-South Corridor, slated for completion in 2026, which will see bus lanes on both at-grade and underground roads and expressways. These transit priority measures developed over the past few decades make bus journeys in Singapore faster, efficient, and more attractive to people, and they are great ways to encourage more people to make the switch to public transit.